being a full day and I being the appetizer, I pray that I will not be before you, Lord.
Well, Jesus.
But all the wells, you leave that up to the Holy Ghost.
Come on,
amen.
Man, I want to say this before I say anything else. In spite of all the hype and statistics that say according and concerning to the African-American male, it doesn't mean that we are lost. Because with God, all things are possible. Amen?
Amen. Yes.
The most important task you will ever have is to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and establish a personal, close-up relationship with God daily, in which you are able to talk with God under any circumstances, anywhere, anytime. In other words, if we have not as men of God, we need to seek sanctification. Because the Lord expects us to live in a manner that honors Him always. The Lord is committed to making all of us holy. Therefore, we must prepare ourselves for this process. If I were to have a topic I pose for a thought this morning, men, your lives matter when you stand in the gap for God. Let us pray. Spirit of the living God. Spirit of the living God. Fall fresh upon this thy house of worship. Fall fresh upon these thy people. And then, Lord, fall fresh on me. Remove me from self. Take my mind, my heart, and my intellect. And with all your impulses, weed it from earth. Speak, Lord. Speak, Lord, for the holy servant listening and is ready to do thy will. Shower down upon me now thy Holy Spirit. And let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable and pleasing in thy sight.
Intercessor,
whom would pray for them as Moses did for the people in of Israel. God says, but I found none. No reformer for the people. No repairer for the breach. No restorer for the past to dwell in. No intercessor for them. Just a good man that would endeavor by his influence to stop the breaking of sin. Worship me from the inside out. Myself because that's the way I used to be. be sold out for Jesus and preparing to see him face to face. You know, God desires a close-up relationship every day, not just Sunday experiences with no acting. In fact, we see worship and fellowship as part of our commitment to every Christian made to God when he made the commitment to save us from heaven. And we've got to give him the honor and honor our God. God's doing his part. He wakes us every day and walks with us all along the way. We must realize and remember that we were raised from the grave to walk in the newness of life. So do it. If your life matters, don't be lukewarm. Don't be cold. Be on fire for God. Committed to the cause of saving this world. Says about men may be caught. Found in Hebrews 20:34. Y'all hold on with me. Let us hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering, for he promised it to be faithful. Therefore, let us consider one another in order to stir up the love and the good works of God in us. We must not forsake the assembly of ourselves together, as in the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much as you see the day approaching. Men, we got to stand in the gap. We got to be more committed. Our lives matter by standing in the gap between the lost and the found. Jesus said, I came to seek and save the lost. If Christ be in you and you be in Christ, that's our mission as well. We must continue to allow Christ to show up through us. It is Jesus we preach and live for, warning every man and teaching every man in all wisdom that we may present every man perfect in Christ Jesus. You see, our commission is to go in all the world and teach the gospel to every creature. The question is, do we testify to those who are lost or complain like Sunday Christians? Even though it may seem useless to witness to the lost, yet that's what we are saved to do. What shall we do? Rebel or just get busy working for Jesus Christ, our Savior and our creature? But he who does not believe shall be condemned. Have we attempted to reach out and teach the lost? The Gospel of James reminds us that a Christian can be so in sin as to be lost. But brother, if any among you wanders from the truth and someone turns you back, let him know that he who turns a sinner from the error of his ways will save a soul from death and a cover a multitude of sins. Amen? Adam, in willfully rebelling against God, lost the communion he had made with God. Ever since then, mankind has been emotionally naked and emotionally in hiding. Men, are you rebelling against God? Oh, glory to his name. Yet God is still seeking those that desire a closer walk and are willing to stand in the gap. Men, when our lives matter, we stand in the gap between right and wrong. Today, right and wrong have become blurred. Murdering innocent children is called pro-choice. Sexual perversion is called alternative lifestyle. Misconception from the will of God is called little white lies or trouble making. Men, we must choose the old paths and hold fast to God's word and call sin sin. Isaiah says, woe to those who call evil good and good evil, who puts darkness in for light and light for darkness, who claims bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter. Romans tells us, men, do not become overwhelmed with evil, but overcome evil with good.
All right now.
Men, we will stand in the gap, for thus says the Lord versus thus says man. We've said for years, speak where the Bible speaks, and be silent where the Bible is silent. as if these truths are our opinions. If teaching is in the Bible, the Word of God, and God speaks the Word, we must stand and should not speak it without authority, without opinions. God's Word must be what we live by instead of worldly practices. As men of God whose lives matter, we must stand in the gap between fear and courage. Not to take away the point that men's lives matter, allow me to use Queen Esther to make my point of interest clear. Esther was afraid to approach the king, even though he was her husband. But she overcome her fear by her faith in God. She was able to have courage enough to approach him and save her people. As men of God, we must live a life without fear. God has promised rest for the weary. Jesus said he was going to prepare a place for us, and if you abide in me, I'll abide in you. Just have faith in him. Have faith and confidence in our Lord, and don't be fearful about nothing. Don't even fear those who will kill the body, because they cannot kill our soul. But rather fear him who is able to destroy both the body and the soul in hell. Yes. Oh, my Lord. Men, often we're reminded, he who has the Son of life has life. He who does not have the Son of God does not have life. He also reminds us, these things I have written before ye who believe in the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life, and that you may not continue to believe in the name of the Son of God. Now, this is the confidence that you have in him. He says, if you ask anything according to my name, he hears us. So therefore, we must stand in the gap between fear and courage. Be strong and courageous. Have no fear. The Lord, your God, will go with you always.
All right now.
Today, I'm reminded of my mentor and a great friend of mine, Bishop John Henry Miller, whom stressed to me the importance of personal relationships with God. Pastors laugh because he knows it. He knew him also. And he stressed to me the personal relationship you must have with God in sanctification. He used to say to me, little preacher, it doesn't mean you are holier than thou. It means you are just set aside to be used by the Lord, and you are filled with a keeper, which is the Holy Ghost. He preached a sermon very eloquently about personal relationships with God, entitled While I Was Musing, the Fire Burning. This sermon reminds me of how we ascend and grow when we listen and obey God obediently. You see, David ascended to the throne of Israel so rapidly that every time he turned around, he was being challenged by war due to envy. David sought the Lord diligently and was victorious because God answered diligently. Only once God took his time answering David, and this was when David was appointed as one of the tabernacle's leading musicians. As David waited for God to answer, he began to muse over his life and his relationship with God. He thought about how God had never failed to do just what he said. And his heart became warm inside as if a fire was burning. David became overwhelmed with joy and said, whatever the outcome, it shall be well with my soul. David knew God would make a way for him to prevail. David relied on God continually. David knew his life was nothing without his relationship with God. David knew that God was his all in all. He knew God was able to do anything but fail. David knew God had directed his life and kept him in spite of his shortcomings. God was his maker and his keeper. David knew that everything was going to time is over.
Yeah.
And what we had is no more ours.
That's right.
It's better to have it and to not need it than to need it and not have it. You got to know the Lord for yourself.
Amen.
David realized that he was disciplined in his life and his relationship with God, just as we must discipline ourselves to God. David had power, wealth, and perhaps anything he wanted. But he just wanted a relationship with God. How many of us this morning have a solid, sold-out relationship with God? It's wonderful to know that Jesus is all we need, isn't it? God is good and he's almighty. It's a joy to have that blessed assurance that Jesus is yours, isn't it?
Yes.
Men, God is seeking us to stand in the gap and to have a closer encounter personally with him. We must realize that God has a plan for all of us.
Yes.
But we've got to be available to be used for what God has for us to do.
Yes.
If you want your life to matter, just lift up Jesus.
Yes.
He's a way maker, a bridge over troubled waters. He can calm the storms in our lives by saying, "Peace be still."
Yes.
He's a doctor when you're sick, a lawyer in the courtroom. Yes. But above all, he's able to keep you victorious.
Yes.
So that one day we'll be able to stand tall for our master and cast a wistful eye over across the Jordan toward the land of Canaan and proudly say, "I know my life matters because on Christ, the solid rock, I stand. All the ground is sinking sand.